The Holy Gospel according to Mark, the 9th chapter.
Glory to you, Lord.
They went on from there and passed through Galilee. He did not want anyone to know it, for he was teaching his disciples, saying to them, "The Son of Man is to be betrayed into human hands, and they will kill him, and 3 days after being killed, he will rise again." But they didn't understand what he was saying, and were afraid to ask him. Then they came to Capernaum, and when he was in the house, he asked them, "What were you arguing about on the way?" But they were silent, for on the way they had argued with one another over who was the greatest. He sat down, called the 12, and said to them, "Whoever wants to be first must be last of all and servant of all." Then he took a little child and put it among them, and taking it into his arms, he said to them, "Whoever welcomes one such child in my name welcomes me, and whoever welcomes me, not only me, but the one who sent me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord.
You may be seated. Grace to the peace of God our Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ. Then Jesus took a little child and put it among them, and taking it into his arms, he said to them, "Whoever welcomes one such child in my name welcomes me, and whoever welcomes me welcomes not just me, but the one who sent me." Welcoming a child is the standard set by Jesus for welcoming him and the one who sent him. Now to me, welcoming a child seems like a very low threshold for determining whether one truly welcomes Jesus and the one who sent him, God. But in Jesus' day and society, children were not particularly welcome. They had no standing in that society. Only male adults had any standing. Even boys who were not yet of age were under the purview of their mothers in the household, not with their fathers. So to welcome a child was to give that boy or girl a little bit of status out in public, something one just didn't do back then. And yet welcoming those without standing or status in the world is what we are called to do as Christians. In Jesus' day, that included children and women, orphans and widows, sinners and tax collectors. In today's society, welcoming those without status might still include welcoming children. Although our society does not have the same status structure that existed in Jesus' day, there are still ways in which our society doesn't care for its children as much as it could. In the United States, over 21% of those under age 18 live in families below the poverty level. 40% of children in the United States will spend at least 1 year in poverty by the time they reach age 18. Earlier this summer, children became pawns in the debate over immigration as nearly 3,000 children were separated from their parents who crossed the southern border of our country, many seeking asylum. As of the end of August, there were still nearly 500 children not yet reunited with their families. Even in less critical realms, there can be an intolerance of children. Several airlines operating out of Australia and Southeast Asia offer child-free zones on their flights. And there are surveys that indicate both anywhere from a third to half of the flying public would like to see other airlines offering the same thing. It would seem that a lot of the flying public is not very welcoming of children. But there are places where children are welcome. Schools, parks, sports, Bible camps, and of course, here in worship and in our Sunday school. And these places of welcome are very important because when we welcome children, when we value them, their gifts and all they have to offer, we guarantee a better future for them and for us. Jesus tells us that those who welcome children in his name welcome him and the one who sent him. And the outcome is similar. By welcoming Jesus and the one who sent him, we again guarantee a better future for ourselves, just as with welcoming children. We are expected to welcome and serve more than just those under 18. We are expected to welcome and serve all of God's children, regardless of how old they are. So that covers just about everyone. We are expected to welcome and serve all people. Even our congregation's mission statement says that. Not just the people we like, not just the people we agree with, not just those who look like us or act like us, not just the people who are worthy, and not just the people who are grateful. We are to welcome everyone. Later on, in the next chapter of Mark, there's a similar situation to the one in today's gospel. People are trying to bring children to Jesus for a blessing, and the disciples try to stop them. Again, that society didn't see a lot of value in children. The disciples apparently think that these children are either a waste of time or a bother to Jesus. In that instance, Jesus responds by saying, "Whoever does not receive the kingdom of God as a little child will never enter it." I want you to think about how a child might react to something as wonderful as the kingdom of God. Perhaps it's how a child might enter an amusement park or Disneyland, eyes wide open in wonderment, jumping up and down with excitement, a big smile on their face, perhaps laughing and giggling. Now ask yourself, when was the last time you felt that way about the kingdom of God? When was the last time you jumped up and down with excitement over the love of Jesus? Unfortunately, as adults, we tend to get weighed down by the not-so-fun parts of life. Work, balancing our checkbook, housekeeping, yard work, parenting. It can leave us drained of any excitement for anything else, including God and Jesus. That's why we need reminders like the ones in today's gospel and in the next chapter of Mark. That's why we need to take every opportunity to celebrate God's gifts, gifts to us and to the whole world. That's why we need to celebrate milestones like the 500th anniversary of the Reformation last year and like the 100th anniversary of this congregation and the years before that. But it's also important to celebrate what may seem like smaller events and accomplishments. Like officially welcoming Mary into our membership in a few minutes. Like the two baptisms we had a few weeks ago. Like the donations you made to the Lutheran World Relief Kits a couple of weeks ago. Like starting Sunday school last week. Like supporting Jasmine as she participated in the AGM last year, which we'll be hearing more about next week. There are many examples all around us, here at the church and around the community, occasions that we can and should celebrate with as much childlike joy as we can muster. So welcome the children. Welcome that which is childlike within each of you and within each of your neighbors. Welcome those who are overlooked in society. Welcome Jesus and the one who sent him. And receive the kingdom of God as a little child, with wonder, excitement.